Hola. We're going to do Virgo. Start off with Virgo. We left with Libra last time, so we used the Hermetic deck here. Holy Spirit, let us know. Let me know what's going on with our Virgos. See what they're going to be dealing with today. What do they need to be aware of? It's the weekend. There's going to be some surprises. What do you got for our Virgos there, Holy Spirit? We got this one first, and this is in the heart of the matter, is lovers. We got underlying, the challenge is the Lord of Established Strength. So Three of Wands, like creating alliances and stuff like that. We got the King of Swords in the subconscious. It's Prince of the Chariot of the Winds. So Taco Bell guy. Windy Bastard here in a wheelchair. Looks like Stephen Hawking. No, I'm just kidding. Stephen Hawking never had that many swords. This guy's got one. He got like 300. Oh, he's got a bunch of little fairies with him too. He's got a bunch of fairies with him. So. With Pentagon Grams tattooed on her head. So I think he's Aquarius and what is he? Aquarius and something else. Some kind of. Swords. King of Swords, King of Swords, Capricorn and Aquarius. Yeah, Capricorn and Aquarius. So, Capricorn and Aquarius, the Three of Wands. Where's my. Just a sec here, guys. I forgot my cheat sheet. Oh, yeah, I need the cheat sheet. Okay. So, we got. What do we got in the past, Spirit? What do we got in the past for our Virgos? Lord of Loss and Pleasure. This could be with, have something to do with like overindulging and drinking too, but it's most mainly loss. Loss and pleasure. So, like be lost by maybe having too many bad habits or, I don't know, being a sucker, like. People just always, like, hustle you or whatever, or shit like that, or you get robbed or whatever, I don't know. Because it's funny how it says in pleasure, because usually it's just loss. But I guess in pleasure, yeah, because it's cups, right? Pleasure is cups, so. I guess you can get pleasure in material things, too, but mainly cups. Oh, what do we got here? In the present, what do we got, Spirit? Queen of Wands in the present energy there, so charismatic queen, for the party, passionate, got a lot of haters, because she's popular, right? So doesn't really go with the grain, maybe not like conform, totally conform, like most people. Okay, what do we got? Two in the future for a Virgo spirit. Future energy. Ooh, that comes out as a blockage because it came out sideways. But oh. My favorite. Yeah, so you might have a blocked tower. There's a tower waiting to happen though. So it just when it comes out like this, it just means it's blocked right now. But that tower's still gonna come down most likely, so. So get ready for a tower in the future. Something's delaying it though. I wonder if it's maybe, we don't know yet. We'll have to check. Okay, what do we got? Influencing the situation. Ooh, that was quick. Four Wands. Lord of Perfected Work. So I call it the G-spot. G-spot double thumb rotor there. Yeah, he's going to try and, hit the sweet spot, I guess. Get the exact rotation on the sugar plum there. What do we got in Hopes and Fears Spirit? Oh, these two? Oh, three. Hey, okay, that works. Got the King of Wands. Fiery King there. The Prince of the Chariot of the Fire. That could be Leo energy because he's got a lion pulling his thing. At the Emperor, which could represent the government or some control. It's Aries energy, though. But it somebody who controls things, the Sun of the Morning. So, the Emperor. And we got the Knight of Wands. So, the fiery bastard. Up this way, he's the he's the postman this way, right? So, yeah, the postman. Look out, guys. Okay, what do we got in the outcome for our Virgos? What do we got in the outcome? Yeah, these two we got that's only two fives, but still. Lord of Prudence, so Lord of Prudence and Lord of Strife. So yeah, like gonna have some conflict in the future with Prudence, so maybe being a little shy with your money. Let's see here. The postman, eh? Okay, he's everybody's fear. When you work, you got to leave here. Post to the Lords of the Money, so the Mighty, Money. The Mighty, so you got a tower coming in. You got, how many kings you got here? You got one, two, the Emperor's considered a king, so three kings. So King of Wands, King of Swords, you got the Lovers, you got Three of Wands, Lord of Established Strength, you got one Queen of Flame, you got one, the Lovers, Gemini there, you got, I see what's going on here. Okay, and yeah, it all ends up in conflict, and that's probably when the conflict, like, strikes off and tees off. That's probably when this fucker drops here. So. What do we got in the underlying energy? Spirit for our Virgos. The Foolish Man, the Eight of Wands, so swift fool. So this fool's not only foolish and gonna come in and fucking do some crazy shit, he's also gonna be really fast. So he's like a fool on speed or whatever. So he's going to be like, whoa. I don't know, man. The fool's a pretty powerful card. Because he's got unlimited possibilities, right? He's just brand new. And he doesn't know too much. So he's going to do a lot of fuck-ups, which are... That's why the Most High always has his back, right? He's always watching him, make sure he doesn't fall off a cliff and shit, because he doesn't know what he'd do. Things probably get boring for him up there, and then every once in a while, when he's bored, he'll, oh, I wonder what the fool's doing. Yeah, so, you know, he may look like a fool, but he's got the Most High protecting him at all times, so he's got, he can really do no wrong, right? And this is a supercharged fool, so... Virgos, look out for that supercharged fool. Might just like do a fucking roadrunner into the blasted tower there and knock it down. So have a good one.